Let's go see how the shooting method works. So let's suppose if we have a differential equation like this, d2y by dx squared is equal to qx, let's call it q times, let's say that it is the function of x, y, dy by dx. Let's go and do the general case. So here you are given the condition at y sub a is y sub a, and at b it is a y sub b. So what you're finding out here is that you are given two boundary conditions. What's happening to y at x equal to a, and what's happening to y at x equal to b. Now what shooting method does is that it basically uses the initial value. It uses the initial value problem methods. So you do have a boundary value problem, but it's going to use initial value problem methods to solve the problem. So what that means is that if you had a second order differential equation, which was of this particular form, and you were solving the initial value method, then you would need the condition at y sub a, which is given at y sub a, and then you would need the condition of y prime of a equal to, let's suppose, let's call it uppercase y sub a. So you can very well see that, let's suppose somebody was saying that, hey, I'm going to use initial value problem methods such as Euler's method, Runge-Kutta second order method, Runge-Kutta fourth order method, and I want to solve this boundary value problem with these boundary conditions. But I want to use initial value problem methods to be able to do that. Now you cannot simply say, okay, hey, we can go ahead and use the initial value problem methods like Euler's method and solve the problem, because initial value problems for a second order differential equation such as this one will require you to have the initial value of y at x equal to a, and also the initial slope at x equal to a. That's the only way you can solve the problem. So what shooting method is all about is that what you're going to do is you're going to say, okay, hey, I know this initial, I know this condition at x equal to a because that's given to me. However, what I'm doing is I'm replacing this condition by this, and I cannot just replace it because I like it. What I'm doing is I'm just replacing this condition by this condition right here, because that's what initial value problem methods are going to require me to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this as my initial value. So what that means is that I'll have to guess this one. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go from A to B. So let's suppose if I am at x equal to A, and the conditions are given x equal to b, I'm going to use my initial condition, which is y sub a is y sub a, and y prime of a is uppercase y sub a, let's suppose. And I'm going to use that to find the value at some point, which is h of a. So whether using Euler's method or Runge-Kutta methods, you're going to find the value of y at this particular point. Similarly, you're going to find the value of y at this particular point by following these numerical methods. And eventually, you're going to end up right here. And what's going to happen is that you're going to get the value of y sub b by this, using some numerical method with the initial value problem. But that y sub b is not going to be the same as this number right here. Why? Because there's no way of knowing that, hey, whether this guess which you are used was appropriate or not. So what you're going to do is you're going to find some value of y sub b. So that's why it's called shooting method, because you're shooting for hoping that the answer, that y sub b, will turn out to be very close or exactly to be this number right here. But that's not going to happen in almost every case, that once you've chosen this initial guess, no matter how good you are at guessing and understanding the physics of the problem, once you have chosen this guess right here, this y sub b is not going to be equal to this y sub b. So what happens is that once you have chosen y sub b, once you have obtained y sub b by using the initial value problem method, such as Euler's method or Runge-Kutta second order method, you're going to choose another value for y prime of a, and let's call it z sub a. So you're going to choose another value, another initial guess, and you're going to get a different y sub b. So let's suppose here you were getting, let's suppose, p. Now, based on this value here, you were getting p. Now, on this value here, you're going to follow the same procedure of starting from here,
with this as the initial value of y, this as the initial value of y prime of a, and take the steps and go all the way up to here, and you're going to get y sub b, let's suppose, equal to q. Now you have some idea of knowing that, hey, if I get by using this value, y sub a, I'm getting the value of p at b, and using this value, I get value of q. Now we can do some kind of an interpolation method to see that, hey, what should I have chosen? What should I have chosen as my initial slope here based on trying to get the value of y sub b to be this y sub b right here? So that's how the shooting method works, and that's why it's called the shooting method, because you are simply trying to guess the initial slope and hoping that the value of y, which will turn out, which is given at the other boundary, will turn out to be close to the number which is given to you. But you can follow a scientific method by choosing another guess, let's suppose, and what happens is that when you choose another guess, you're going to get another value of y sub b, and based on some interpolation technique, you can say, okay, hey, I want y sub b not to be p, not to be q, but I want it to be y sub b. What should I choose as my initial values of y prime of a?
All of these things will be very clear once we do an example, but you do need to understand the theoretical basis of the shooting method. And that's the end of this segment.